In X-ray CT, we always want to remain conscientious of the radiation dose we give to patients during diagnostic exams. Low-dose protocols are therefore desirable, but suffer from poor signal-to-noise, which can then be corrected by iterative or deep learning reconstruction techniques. Using the raw X-ray projection data is therefore useful, but these sinograms are often vendor proprietary, which limits the amount of high-quality data available for developing these advanced reconstruction approaches. In this work, we propose a dual-domain cascade of units to denoise the filtered back projection of low-dose CT data. Specifically, we apply a unit to the image domain reconstruction and a second unit to its corresponding spatial frequency spectrum in order to learn a convolutional filter that suppresses high spatial frequency noise while preserving frequencies that correspond to true spatial features. The purpose of this work was to determine the optimal domain processing order for our dual domain approach. As a baseline benchmark, we train two single domain units operating in the image domain, which we call I unit, and the spatial frequency domain, which we call F unit for frequency or Fourier domain. We additionally train two cascades of units, which we call W units, that operate in only one domain, for example, image then image, or frequency then frequency. Finally, we train our proposed dual domain W nets. The FIWNet first processed the spatial frequency domain, then the image domain, and the IFWNet processed the image domain, then the spatial frequency domain. We used a 2D fast Fourier transform to obtain the spatial frequency spectrum, then an absolute inverse Fourier transform to revert back to the image domain, which was always the final output of each network. Data were from the AAPM Low-dose CT Grand Challenge, which consisted of a set of 10 patients with suspected metastatic liver lesions who obtained routine dose contrast-enhanced body CT imaging from which a quarter dose acquisition was simulated. Patients were split 5:2:3 for training, validation, and testing, and min-max normalization scaled the network inputs between 0 and 1. Each of the 6 network configurations were trained end-to-end over 30 epochs using the Atom optimizer and a constant learning rate of 10⁻⁴. We used an early stopping of 10 and real-time data augmentation by applying affine transforms on the training images to reduce model overfitting. We used a perceptual loss function, which was a weighted sum of multi-scale structural similarity and absolute error, which were computed in the respective domains on which the networks operated. Each unit contained approximately 11.5 million parameters. The figure on the top left shows an example of the denoising performance of each of our 6 approaches. We see qualitatively that noise was suppressed using any of our tested approaches, but the frequency domain-only networks produce coarse textures that reduce our confidence in diagnostically reading the image. The image domain-only and the dual domain approaches produced similar qualitative results, with the FIWNet producing slightly sharper results. The bar plots on the right show there were no significant quantitative differences within the same domain configuration, for example, the IUNet versus the IIWNet, and the order didn't matter in the dual domain WNets. The dual domain approaches had the best quantitative metrics by a small margin to the image domain metrics. So in this study, we propose a dual domain cascade of units operating in the spatial frequency and image domains, and we chose the spatial frequency domain as a way of applying a learned convolutional filter following an initial filtered back projection. We found that the dual domain approach was quantitatively superior to both image domain and spatial frequency domain units and WNets, but there were minimal qualitative differences between the image domain and the dual domain approaches. The poor qualitative results of the spatial frequency domain network can be attributed to the perceptual loss function that was minimized in the frequency spectrum rather than the image domain representation. So while the frequency spectrums may appear qualitatively accurate, the same cannot necessarily be said for the final image domain output. Our approach faces similar challenges in overly smooth results as prominently seen in the literature. Even though signal-to-noise is substantially improved, the noise characteristics of the routine dose image are not captured in any of the processed images. A limitation of our study was our limited dataset, as it was a single-institution, single-scanner study of only 10 patients. We also did not investigate the effects of the reconstruction kernel, which may be an immediate factor since we are operating directly in the spatial frequency domain. Finally, we did not compare our results to competing techniques in the literature, and it's definitely future work to consider. Thank you.